Hi, I'm Guy from Scoop. Configurations of MikroTik devices can seem daunting to anybody just starting out. However, MikroTik commands a strong global market share precisely because of the granular control you can exercise. The tech community loves their creative approach to finding different ways of doing things. If you're new to MikroTik, we'll help you overcome these initial hurdles and welcome you into a world of networking possibilities. Welcome to the second video in our MikroTik Back to Basics series. If you're only joining us now, fear not. Today's configuration will achieve an identical result to our previous video where we set up a Wi-Fi 5 or AC access point. Now we'll do it with a Wi-Fi 6 or AX device. There's only a slight difference. For this example, we're using this great looking HAP AX2. We're starting out as previously with no configuration at all. On the software side, we're using the latest version of MikroTik's Winbox to log into the device. At this time, it's version 4.0, beta 12. When logging into your Wi-Fi 6 or AX device, ensure that you log in via the MAC address by clicking on that item. We do this because there is no IP assigned yet, and also so that changes made to the IP don't disconnect you each time. Once logged in, start by navigating to the Bridge option and add a new bridge. Now go to the Ports tab. Here, we need to add each of the interfaces that we'd like included into the created bridge. In doing so, all the interfaces can communicate with one another freely. Next, we need to give the device an IP address. For the automatic option, navigate to IP, DHCP client, and then add a new interface specifying the bridge interface under the DHCP header. Now plug the device into the network and the bridge will get an IP assigned to it automatically. To set a static IP, navigate to IP, addresses, and add one. In the address box, we'll use 192.168.24.10/24 since that is part of the range that our main network is handing out. Make sure to specify the subnet/24 so that the interface knows the network and broadcast IPs. Select the bridge as the interface that this IP applies to and click OK. At this point, note that our Wi-Fi settings on the MikroTik AX devices are configured differently to the wireless on the MikroTik AC devices. So if you're on a Wi-Fi 5 device, please check out our first video in this series. Now we can start with the wireless configuration. On the Wi-Fi 6 or AX devices, head to the Wi-Fi option. In the window, you'll notice that the interfaces are grayed out, indicating that they're disabled. We're only configuring the 5 GHz interface in this example, but the method is identical for 2.4 GHz, and you can do both to complete your setup. Double-click the Wi-Fi 1 interface to open the window. Tick the Enabled checkbox. Name the interface something that you can identify. We'll use 5 GHz. Set the mode to AP. With MikroTik's AX devices, keep in mind that the configurations can be made as templates and then selected from a drop-down menu to use in the relevant sections of Wi-Fi configuration. We're not using any templates, but we'll rather configure the settings directly on the interface for our demo. In the configuration section, our SSID is set to HAP AX2-5 GHz so that we know what to connect to once configuration is complete. Set the country to where you are so your device abides by that country's regulatory ranges and power limits. In the channel section, set the band to 5 GHz AX to get Wi-Fi 6 connectivity to the access point. The channel width is set to 20, 40, 80 MHz for the best throughput possible with this device. We set the frequency to a range of 5180 to 5850 MHz. But you can use any frequency or range permitted for your region. In the security section, we'll change just the authentication types and passphrase. For authentication types, we select WPA2 PSK and WPA3 PSK to make it secure. The passphrase is the password that you use to connect to the wireless. Use whatever you would like here. Now you can click OK. You now have a functioning Wi-Fi 6 AP with DHCP pass-through. Any client devices connecting to the bridged Ethernet ports or wireless interfaces will be able to get access to the rest of the network. Please like and subscribe, and join us in the next video where we'll perform a basic router configuration. Thanks for watching. I'm Guy from Scoop.